The flying forearm finds his target.
The four men in the ring are set. One of the most chaotic contests a superstar can compete in is a fatal four-way. Anything can happen, and the match can be over in an instant.
Yeah, but these competitors will have their hands full, Cole. In a fatal four-way, you have to have your head on the swivel at all times.
Oh, man, right to the arm. Hyperextend your elbow. We may have discovered his favorite move.
Hooked up. Belly to back suplex.
And he lands a savage elbow. Drop down.
With a big boot.
On the mark.
Bad spot for him to be in here, guys.
He's got to do something to get back in this thing.
Oh, you cannot take your eyes off him for a second.
Really?
Perhaps a unique suplex.
Wrist clutch suplex. Perfect.
He's starting to stumble here.
Oh.
It'll be interesting to see how he responds here in this four-way environment.
The fatal four-way match works like this. Four superstars are in the ring all at once. There are no countouts and no disqualifications. You have four superstars who are throwing down in the ring all at the same time, and they can fight anywhere they want to. It's mass hysteria.
Corey, you talked about the ground rules of a fatal four-way match. One thing to keep in mind is that depending on the stipulation, there could be eliminations in the match, meaning that once a superstar is pinned, taps out, is counted out, or is disqualified, they are eliminated from the match. But the battle wages on.
And a stipulation can change the entire complexion of a match. As one may think, a fatal four-way can see an interesting breakdown of temporary allies. No countouts and no disqualifications means anything can happen, and it can happen anywhere. Since there are no disqualifications in a fatal four-way match, a superstar has to be aware of the fact that if they're in an elimination fatal four-way match, someone who was eliminated can come back for retribution, and it's all legal. So you can eliminate an opponent, and they can interfere in the match later, and there's nothing anyone can do about it.
Ooh, what an upper! Myron, you touched on something earlier that's worth repeating. If you're a superstar competing in a fatal four-way elimination match and a competitor is eliminated, they can look to settle a score and affect the outcome of the match later. That's always a possibility in a fatal four-way match because of the no disqualification stipulation.
Michael, that's what I like to call an occupational hazard. We saw an example of that in 2016 during the fatal four-way elimination match to determine the number one contender for the WWE Championship. The Miz was eliminated from the match, but let's say he had a major influence on the outcome of the contest. Just ask Dean Ambrose.
In a career filled with highlights, one of Rey Mysterio's shining moments, Byron, would have to be his victory in the 2006 Royal Rumble match.
I co-sign that statement for sure, Michael, especially when you consider Mysterio entered that match in the number two position. Talk about beating the odds. But I guess that shouldn't surprise us. Mysterio has had a long history of beating the odds.
Oh boy, he is rolling.
The thing about Mysterio's Royal Rumble match victory that you guys mentioned is not only did he come in at number two, but he also had to last more than an hour just to be the last.
Big move coming!
Wait for it!
Rocks him with a series of kicks.
This could be it.
You can't teach that type of talent.
Second time we're seeing this here. Seems to me, guys, like we're just moments away from seeing the finisher, which could obviously put this match on ice. That's a great example of a highly efficient and highly effective strike. What placement! Wow, I think this man means business. Great move by him right there.
Yeah, let's see that one again. The finisher could absolutely end this match, Michael, as you were saying, but it's not a guarantee.
Yes! Takes it!
No doubt that was a match people will be telling their kids about for years to come. Here's another look.
Count yourselves lucky, people. You might watch WWE for years and only see a match that good
a few times.
Big win here to start the show. I tell you, I don't think the average viewer at home truly understands exactly how much endurance goes into winning a match of this nature. Believe it or not, that's just the beginning, folks.
Introducing first, standing 7 feet tall, weighing in at 385 pounds, The Big Show!
Strutting to the ring. One of the all-time greats, possibly in the best physical condition of his career right now. I think he's on B-Sax's diet.
That's a great thing.
WWE Universe, here comes the reckoning. Stop these two. You don't.
Both legal men are in the ring set to start things off here. We're ready to go.
And whichever team wins this match here tonight can absolutely make an argument for being one of WWE's top teams.
Well, let me tell you, I shook hands with the Big Show, and afterwards, I couldn't hold a pen for hours.
Saxton, you're a liar. The Big Show would never shake your hand.
Super kick!
Right to the face. Back suplex.
Ooh. Very nice.
Super kick!
That was such a hard fall. That could take all the energy right out of you.
Elbow drop!
Military boom!
I must say, fellas, I was absolutely shocked when I saw the latest weekly rankings. How in the world did this superstar secure such a high spot?
Look at that tremendous ring presence.
Very impressive.
Using every ounce of his body on that splash.
As we've seen many times over the years, the weekly rankings can be a source of great debate. Byron, it seems Corey has taken issue with this week's rankings. Do you have any issue with how this week's numbers played out?
Not at all, Michael. In fact, I applaud the voters for getting, in my opinion, everything right from top to bottom.
A mat slam
with some attitude.
Knee drop.
That was nasty.
So precise.
Oh, man.
Unleashing it for the second time now.
Uh-oh. Up, man. What stands out with the Big Show is obviously his size, but don't let his 7-foot-tall, 383-pound stature fool you into thinking that he has limited moves. Big Show has some tools in his arsenal that would shock you.
Looks like this show is over, guys. Oh, man, Big Show is in trouble now.
The moveset Corey alluded to is something Big Show's been putting on display more often as of late. Perhaps as a message, he's fighting back here.
I expected nothing less, Cole.
In WWE, there's as much chaos outside the ring as there is inside the ring.
Try working with Saxton at ringside.
Tagged in. He's so close to making the tag. There it is. The tag has been made.
Oh, he needed that in the worst way, Michael.
Just go for the finisher already. I don't understand the delay. The object is to win the match, isn't it? Come on. Let's go.
Looks like a power bomb coming up.
There may be no escaping this one, Cole.
Yes, and Rowan may have just closed the book on this one.
Incredible.
As Corey continues to criticize the action in the ring, allow me to take the other side of the argument. The last thing any superstar wants to do is go for the finisher prematurely. No good can come of that.
Yeah, you really want to wait for the exact right time. If you go for it and miss, that could be the momentum shift your opponent has been waiting for.
This is what makes him one of the best in the business.
Oh, and a strong Irish whip.
Drives him down with a power bomb.
What does R-Truth have to do at this point to stay in this match?
If they want to win this match, he really needs to make a tag soon.
Why he's still in the match at this point is beyond me, guys. Maybe he forgot it's a tag team match. I don't know. There's got to be...
Yes, and Rowan may have just closed the book on this one.
Got every ounce of that one. This could be over.
Guys, some are saying this superstar has begun showing a bit of arrogance since the latest weekly rankings were released. But the way I see it, that's just confidence.
There certainly is a fine line between arrogance and confidence, as Byron was saying, but whatever it is, I have no problem with it. This superstar has been on an absolute roll as of late.
And who really cares if somebody's being arrogant? As the old saying goes, if you got it, flaunt it. And this superstar certainly has it.
Oh, what incredible power! Wow, what a vertical suplex!
R-Truth is getting a serious beatdown. Not sure how much more anyone would be able to take. At this point, his confidence has to be at zero.
We may very well be seeing the finisher here very shortly, guys, and when that happens, you can bet this one's gonna be over.
Behind it.
I'm with Corey. I suspect the finisher is on the horizon, and given how impactful that move has been as of late, I'd say there's almost no coming back from it.
You're right, Michael. It seems like that finisher has become more and more impactful with each passing week, if that's even possible.
And just like that, this move is leading the charge.
The weekly rankings are up, guys, and this superstar,
Rowan, big move coming up.
Close fist.
The human body can only absorb so much of that.
I don't like how for R-Truth.
They did it! Wow, what a match! Byron, I can't see how you get a better tag team victory than you just saw there.
That was nice.
Yeah, no love lost between these two teams, that's for sure.
This tag team rubbing their victory in the face of their fallen opponents.
So painful. Jeez.
The damage has been done. Clearly on a mission here. Singles action is underway, and in this one, I wouldn't attempt to predict what's going to happen. I'd just be ready for anything. Sometimes that's all you can do.
When you have competitors on the level of these women, you just know it's going to be a great match.
She gets her with the fist.
Very difficult position to be in right now.
Yeah, situations like this usually don't end very pleasantly.
Targeting the back now.
Perhaps thinking about what to do next here.
Well, better not think too long, though.
You're not supposed to get dropped like that. Gals, Carmella may be in a bad way here.
She doesn't appear too concerned, however.
If you're worried about her now, you haven't seen many of her matches. She can withstand so much more punishment than this.
She's looked off her game almost all night here, guys. And to be honest, I'm a little surprised.
She clearly liked the results from the first time she delivered that move.
Not the first time we've seen this move tonight.
Definitely not where you want to be right now.
Gotta find a way to get out of this, Michael.
Coming up big on that one. Oh, right to the kidneys.
Golly.
Carmella with a nice reversal.
If you remember, guys, Carmella's introduction to the main roster came in 2016 when she was the final pick in the WWE brand extension draft.
Single leg drop kick.
There we go again.
Byron noted it.
Here.
Look at her go.
Hits with the clothesline.
She is on fire.
Mandy Rose. Well, that
shoulders down. Rolled up.
One, two, three.
There's the pinfall. And the victory.
Hard to imagine, but that match was even better than advertised. Here's another look at that history-making encounter.
Here is your winner, the Princess of Staten Island, Carmella.
What a check of a win column for Carmella
to get the pinfall victory over such a high.
The phenomenal AJ Styles.
Seemingly endless. Styles a true global superstar before arriving in WWE.
And his opponent from St. Louis, Missouri, weighing in at 250 pounds. the WWE Champion. He is the Apex Predator.
What's this? Well, I think it's about to be a highlight reel.
Wait a minute, we need to get some order back in this.
Oh, man!
Trap the arm.
Floored by the neck breaker.
Hits him with the uppercut.
Oh, man!
Oh, man, right to the arm.
Hyperextend your elbow.
Going to be anything traditional about this one-on-one matchup.
With AJ Styles in the ring, you know this match is going to be absolutely phenomenal.
Yeah, the only thing I could possibly dislike about the match is that you're calling it with me.
Oh, what an uppercut. Oh, man.
In position for a power bomb.
And that's not a good place to be, Cole.
Looks like a power bomb coming up.
There may be no escaping this one, Cole.
That slam put him in a bad way, guys.
Oh, my goodness, crushing it.
Receiving a ranking like the one this superstar did this past week has to be such an amazing motivator. Now let's see if he equates it to another victory here tonight. Randy Orton is on the attack.
Flattens him with a clothesline.
Looks like he's pinpointing the back.
He lands a piercing chop. On the flip side of what Byron was saying earlier, we've seen superstars relax a bit after being slotted high in the rankings. And that, of course, is the last thing you want to do in a situation like this.
Well, I don't think we have to worry about that with this superstar, Cole. Some competitors are known for believing their own hype, but that's definitely not the case here.
When this guy's on, look out.
Good night. Victory is on the horizon.
Looking for an opening for that finisher, it seems, and that's a smart move. Just hit the finisher, get the win, and get out of there.
Up across the shoulders.
Going to the top, high risk.
Uh-oh. Oh, my God, what a move.
Anytime a superstar sees an opening for their finisher, they got to take it, as Byron was.
AJ Styles may have it.
Oh, the reversal by AJ Styles.
Looks like Randy Orton has broken a sweat, but he's not appearing too worse for wear, at least not yet anyway.
He's doing exactly what he didn't want to do here. He's letting his opponent right back into this match.
Took his head off.
He's in control.
Believe it or not, guys, this superstar wasn't overly pleased with this past week's rankings. And you know what? I tend to agree. Who's voting on this stuff anyway?
And a reverse DDT.
There's been a lot of talk about this superstar's latest spot in the power rankings, but if you ask me, those things are overblown.
Well, while I disagree with Corey's assessment of this week's rankings, I do support his right to an opinion. And you, too, can voice your opinion on this week's rankings by using hashtag WWE Power Rankings on social media.
And I'm seeing a lot of varying opinions, which is great. Though, interestingly enough, I don't see any that agree with what Corey was saying. Go figure.
Oh, man, low clothesline.
AJ Styles is not looking so good here.
I have a feeling this isn't going to end well for him.
He has got to fight back.
AJ Styles might be headed for a rear loss unless he turns things around.
Clothesline in the corner.
I don't know what he has planned out here, but he must be mindful of the referee's count.
Bravo to the voters this past week. It seems they finally got the rankings right. And I know this superstar agrees with me. It's about time.
Styles looks like he wants to do it all by himself.
Twice.
It might be cliche, but it's true here. It ain't over till it's over.
Nobody controls the pace of a match quite like this guy.
I gotta say, when I saw this week's power rankings,
but he's running on fumes here. Does he have enough left in him to capitalize?
And if you thought the first one was brutal.
Well, while Corey lauds the power rankings voting process, I will say that there are more than a few people who think a few mistakes were made this past week, particularly as
Orton looking to get off.
That's it. He's got it. Let's see it once more.
Yeah, this match is all but over.
Randy Orton looking to end this.
Great job escaping, trying to turn this thing around.
He's making a statement here with this attack.
Oh, and he connects.
There's no reason to lose your footing on a move like that. Come on, toughen up.
You got to think about using the finisher here pretty soon, I would think. Just pick up the win and move on. There's no need to keep this thing going longer than necessary.
He's focusing on the face down. If an opponent exhibits a weakness for a specific move, some overturn to utilizing that move as long as possible. He hits the clothesline. Good point by Byron earlier. If there's an opening to execute the finisher, you got to take it. The last thing you want to do is let your opponent hang around for no reason. I can tell you bad things happen when you do that. If you don't believe me, just go back and watch Skip versus Barry Horowitz from 1995.
I remember that like it was yesterday, Cole. Instead of putting Horowitz away, Skip thought it would be a good idea to do some mid-ring push-ups. And as you were saying, the decision ultimately came back to haunt.
Got him caught.
You got to think about using the finisher here pretty soon, I would think. Just pick up the win and move on. There's no need to keep this thing going longer than necessary.
Boom! What a right! Around the world on the WWE Network, WWE fans are glued to their sets watching this match.
Good point by Byron earlier. If there's an opening to execute the finisher, you got to take it. The last thing you want to do is let your opponent hang around for no reason. I can tell you bad things happen when you do that. If you don't believe me, just go back and watch Skip versus Barry Horowitz from 1995.
I remember that like it was yesterday, Cole. Instead of putting Horowitz away, Skip thought it would be a good idea to do some mid-ring push-ups. And as you were saying, the decision ultimately came back to haunt it.
Crushing damage to the back. Here's the cover. Oh, man.
Oh, boy, he is rolling.
Oh, man. And now he goes for it a second time. This superstar comes in here tonight with a pretty impressive ranking guy.
Oh, no. Randy Orton looking to finish it.
It.
We've seen plenty of fireworks thus far tonight on this Independence Day edition of WWE programming.
DDT!
What is Randy Orton's best strategy at this point? And at this point, you have to wonder if he can recover from this.
The bottom line here is that despite what's going on right now, he's still in much more favorable health than his opponent.
He's fighting back here.
I expected nothing less, Cole.
Orton looking for some
RKO out of nowhere.
That's how you put it next.
He's looking for the win. Never say die attitude out of him.
There's a reason AJ is one of the greatest performers in sports entertainment, folks.
Drops the elbow on him. Look at this. He's going back to an old friend with that one.
And here comes Orton.
suplex off the top rope.
What a brutal beating we've seen dished out so far here tonight.
Got all of that one.
Chaos, melee, pandemonium.
And Randy Orton just slips out of harm's way.
Boom! What a right. Gosh.
There may be no coming back from this incredible beatdown.
Talk about getting flung around.
He has him right where he wants him.
He's close to being done.
Oh, boy. The RKO. This one is over.
Momentum is fully in the corner of Randy Orton now.
Randy better not lose focus on what matters, and that's winning this match.
Five.
And he's heading back in.
A lot of people are questioning how this superstar got such a favorable.
Wow.
AJ's in big trouble.
He goes down hard.
AJ's in big trouble now.
AJ's witnessing a level of punishment that can only be described as severe.
AJ's in big trouble now.
Oh, man. AJ Styles is in trouble.
Looks like he might have an answer.
Nobody controls the pace of the
world. AJ's in big trouble now.
I can't believe this one's still going on, especially after the beating that's been delivered tonight.
Dangerous spot for him to be in.
He's got to figure out a way to get back in it, guys.
He took an incredible pounding there.
AJ's in big trouble now.
He got him there.
Just look at this, Cole. Wow.
This singles match in the books.
Let's take a little look at some of the action for that match. Wow.
I can watch highlights of that one all night long. One of the great WWE matches I've ever been able to watch. Wow. I haven't seen a match like that in a long time. I might go home and watch a replay.
Here comes Orton.
How's that for ferocious?
Looks like someone hit the repeat button for this move.
Randy Orton is getting no way. What a move from Randy Orton.